Good morning, everyone. My name is Jung Hyun-jo, Professor Jang Shin-che in Catholic University of Korea, and I worked together for this case study. And I am going to present this study today. I am working at the social enterprise Mindule Co-Housing. Mindule means dandelion. Yes. And I am also studying about co-housing and resident participation. I am not good at English, so I am going to read my note. I hope you to understand it. The topic of this study is the formation process of international community and example for resident participation, the Baekhwa community, South Korea. This slide shows the outline about the presentation, and I passed to explain background because of the timeline. The starting point of this study was the question, what is the meaning of a house to us? In other words, the very fundamental question, what is the good house to live in? What house are you living now, and what do you think about really a good house? As you expected, I would like to find the answer for this question from the international community. This page I'm passing. This is background. Yes. And now I'm talking about Baekhwa Village. The reason why Baekhwa Village was selected as the subject of this study was that this village is not public driven but resident driven. In addition, this international community village is the most similar type with co-housing in Korea. Baekhwa Village is located in Yeongdong-gun, Chungcheong-bukdo, and it is 2 hours in above Seoul, and from 30 minutes from Daejeon. The top picture shows the village view, and the picture on the right shows the village site plan. Baekhwa Village was supported by the Ministry of Food, Agriculture, Forestry, and Fishery as the rural village supporting business. And this village was formed by 40 families who decided to return to farming and return to a village. They constructed residential public facilities, and the government conducted infrastructures. It took 4 years from 2008 and to 2012 to form this village. And people started moving into here from February 2012. So now 1 year and 4 months have passed since then. Most of the residents were age of 30s and 40s who want to provide a nature environment for their children. And residents who were 50s and 60s were the people who returned to farming and returned to a village. Therefore, the village consists of a social mix which was throwing punks to senior citizens. There were homepage and internet cafe for this village, and particularly this cafe was very active. This is the homepage of the Baekhwa Village. And this picture of internet cafe for the cyber meeting of the Baekhwa residents. In the physical feature of the Baekhwa Village, the total area was like this, and residential section area was this. Yes. and remaining area was forest. Yes.
Forest?
Yeah. The house structure was wood based stone and its material was red clay, straw bale. The house plan type shown here. As you see, there are several kinds of house plan that reflect individual opinion about bedroom and bathroom. In the village, there was a center of education and culture as a main facility for public living space, and its size was 680 square meters, and it was a two-story buildings. Additionally, there were village forest and yard, public stadium, playground, and so forth. Let's see the establishment process of the village. In 28, suitable land was decided after the rural village supported business was confirmed in 29. The residents prepared to form the village by starting with Todd School, we call Dukkobi Hakkyo, in 2010. In the summer, they considered and designed together the Center of Education and Culture as a residential public facility through Todd School program. In 2011, the residential public facilities and houses were constructed, and in February 2012, the residents started moving into this village with a new hope. In the resident-driven process of this village establishment, a lot of the resident activity participated, and I would like to introduce some of them. First of all, would like to talk about the Todd School, Dukkobi Hakkyo, where all the residents had a meeting once a month or every 2 months during their village establishment. This meeting was important because in this meeting, they talk about the progress of the village establishment, discussed and made a decision. From February 2010, when the village started being formed, to February 2012, when people started moving into the village, six times of the meeting were continued for about 2 years. Among these, nine times of the meeting provided the seminars to teach the diverse matters of the village. The next one is the community newspaper. The 10 newspapers were published, and this presented the progress of the village establishment and the resident common stories. Additionally, among the nine seminars, there were two seminars that provided the design workshop for the residents. When designing the Center of Education and Culture as a public living space in the village, the residents participated and designed it together for their own space. I have also read this workshop. The last one is the Resident Association. There were the village maintenance union and the village development committee to operate the overall progress of the village establishment. The upper picture shows the proceeding of the Todd School and the material for the nine seminars. The topic of the seminars were the sustainable village, energy independent village, social business, co-housing, playground for culture and art, alternative school, agriculture association, and example of the success on returning the farming, living in the community, and so forth. The raw picture showed the 10 community newspaper. This table shows the contents of the first resident participation design workshop. In this workshop, they thought about how they wanted to use the public living space in the village. And based on those ideas, they designed the space, scale, and the distribution together. For this, the seminar was progressed by the five groups presentations to appropriately organize the space. This table shows the contents of the second workshop. Based on the decision by the first workshop, the architect designed the public living facility, and the residents had the second workshop with the designed drawing. The second workshop was the process to check the space by virtual planning the space used based on that design drawing. The workshop was proceeded by four groups, and they tried to make the name for each space, throw about the public activity programs, and talk about the expected problems when they use those spaces in real life. And then they also tried making rules for the public living space and play the role game. Therefore, this workshop helped them understand the designed public living facilities and share their feedback for correction and supplementation. This picture shows the first and second resident participation design workshop. And these are the floor plan, three-dimensional plan, and the picture of the public living space. Second floor and first floor. Yeah, the one first floor, there are the library, children's room, office, woodwork room, sound space, multi-purpose space, restroom, and machinery room. On the second floor, there are the cafeteria, cafe, and hall, guest room, and lecture room. And it has a very good accessibility from the village because it can be accessed through with side, including the front, back, and side. As this picture shows, this building was eco-friendly constructed by using wood and straw bale. Now, I would like to talk about the resident autonomy management and public activities. The resident worked for various resident autonomy management and public activities. There are village autonomy rules, and those contents were shown here. When we looked in the village organization in detail, there were village managing committee, women's society, steering committee, and several project management committee, and all of them were voluntarily and democratically operated. Here are the list of the community activities. These activities have been activities proceed in the community. Because of the lack of the community life experience, it is just a little longer than 1 year. And there were some trial and errors. However, the important factor was that the community was growing through cooperative management on common facility in the community. Recently, there was an initiation of the community culture from the local government aid. This movement is expanding to the native people and the neighboring community beyond the Beko village. In the future, they would be a green energy experience village construct plan. This picture shows the community activities. The first top left picture is about the community workshop for the construct plan of the green energy experience village. The second top right picture is the snow removing work in the community. The third bottom left picture is the opening ceremony of the Hugh Community Cafe. The last bottom of the right picture is a Korean traditional New Year celebration called Sebe, New Year's Ball for the senior citizen in the community. In addition to these activities, there are many other community activities. Now let me comment on the last ground conclusion. The emerging international community beliefs and community participation process are the rediscovery of the community life in Korea. Through this movement, the housing issue in Korea could be overcome. The successful settlement of the early step of the International Community Beliefs Project has the following important content. Above all, the active and voluntary participation of the residents is a crucial factor. Particularly, the resident needs to be more familiar in the community mind sharing and process concept. If it does not happen, there would be a drop off from the community. In the case of the backup village, there are some considerations on the residents' participation. It must have a positive impact on building fine house and village. Through these considerations, step again in the future. Do you remember the first question I made at the beginning of this presentation? What is good house to live in? The answer is the harmonious living with people and surrounding. In conclusion, I believe that it is important to go back to the basic and fundamental living based on the local life concern, connecting the whole world with relationships. I'd like to close my presentation. Thanks for your attention. Thank you.